Hey everybody, how's it going? Just wanted to do a quick follow-up on my review for the Line 6 G30 wireless unit. My good friend Ryan Bruce chimed in and had something very important to say.
You know, there is a fix for that. It's magic. Watch. Goes into the pouch. Also, fuck you, Glenn.
If you guys haven't checked out Ryan's show, please do. It is guitar-centric. It is absolutely incredible. And if you haven't, make sure you get subscribed to him. I'll leave a link in the description below. He's awesome. Anyway, so my review was actually on the Line 6 unit itself. And, you know, that hasn't changed. The housing is still terrible. The clip will break. And the battery door is a liability. So if you absolutely don't have the budget to get the next model up, which would be the G50, which is all metal construction and is roadworthy and will survive regular gigging, and you have to get the G30, please do yourself a favor and get the pouch. It's going to save you a lot of grief, especially if the clip breaks or the battery door breaks. It's something that's going to kind of hold everything together. So yeah, good on that. Now, a bunch of you guys were asking why I didn't do an A-B comparison between a straight cable and the G30. And I didn't really think it was relevant, to be honest with you, because if you're playing at this level, you're probably going to be playing gigs where the only people in attendance are going to be the other band's girlfriends and maybe your parents, and they're not going to give a shit. They will notice dropouts, but they're not going to notice any kind of real signal degradation. That being said, you know what? Okay, fine, fuck it. It's might be a good idea. So I read a couple brief tests here with myself playing, and bear in mind, I am a terrible clean player. So I kept everything dead simple just to hear a quick A-B. Let's check that out. Okay, you know what? I really can't hear much of a tonal shift, if any. So hats off to Line 6 for getting the wireless part of this right. Like I said, I had no problem with the transmission or any of that. There doesn't seem to be a signal degradation. It's got a hell of a range. It's got a hell of a distance. So my final conclusion on this is the housing is still terrible. The battery door is a liability and the clip will more than likely break on you. So if you do want to get this, bear in mind, you will absolutely have to get a pouch for it because otherwise it's just not going to survive. That being said, it does transmit and does do the job well in that respect. So I will put some links in the description for you guys to check out. Thanks again for watching and thanks to everybody for commenting on the first video. Take care.